What's up, guys? This is Dakota from SND Entertainment, and this is episode 3 of our adventure through Resident Evil 4. Now, in the last episode, we met the village guy right there. He tried to kill us, but decided not to because we shared the same blood as him. If you remember, that's because they injected us with the virus that basically is going to kill us if we don't do anything about it. So, is that a syringe? No, it's a wine bottle. Never mind. But, yeah, so, basically now we're heading to the church so we can find Ashley and return her to safety because we still need to do our job even though this place is creepy as heck. Ooh. Looks like the people in this house eat like normal humans. Not very often. Ooh, my hands go through this painting. I am Picasso. Anyway, the reason why I kind of wanted to look at that is because later in the game, you see paintings like that, and you can move them off the wall and get more fine money. So, let's keep going. We should encounter some more enemies. I haven't played this in like a few days, so I kind of forgot what we had, but it looks like we're kind of set up to beat this, so let's just hurry up and do this. I'm going to kill him instead of trying to like speed past him because we want to get as much money as we can because we want to keep up on upgrading our weapons along with making sure that we can buy whatever. Oh god! Oh boy. Please ignore my head rolling down the hill, sir. Wow. Dakota pro tip. Always check your ammo. And I wish I could just skip. There we go. Wow. whoops. Maybe I should pay attention a little bit more. That was definitely not supposed to happen. Your head is supposed to stay on your shoulders, believe it or not. Oh my god, that scared me. I remember seeing that for the first time, and just scared the crap out of me, because it's kind of gruesome, especially when you're not playing in HD, and it's like grainy 480 on a Wii. So, yeah, let's reload real quick, because I don't want that to happen again. It looks even more gross or just more gruesome because it's just super grainy. And also I would rather not have my head torn off of my shoulder in probably one of the worst ways possible. Imagine how much that would hurt, just having someone take a chainsaw to your neck and just cut it off. I imagine it probably doesn't feel too good. I'd imagine that doesn't feel good either, but let's just use this. Oh, that was easy. Maybe we can. Oh god, please, please, please. Okay. I thought I screwed up again. Not happening this time. Get that ruby. I think it's like another $10,000 or whatever the currency is in this game. So it's definitely a lot of money and kind of worth it to take a minute or two to try to kill him. Use whatever you can. Explode their head. Okay, and we ran into the problem of that we don't have that much inventory space left, and I messed up and should have just combined the red one with the yellow one, so we don't have to find a yellow one, and we just had to find a red and yellow one, but we'll edit it in post. Kill you. Oh god, please reload. Man, I don't know what's wrong with me today. That's just so many times where I've just almost killed myself because I'm not smart enough to reload before I continue trying to slaughter them. And then take the time to actually reload instead of just running away. Let's make sure we reload our weapons and stuff. Because apparently that might be a recurring theme of me being stupid, not having ammo, and then being decapitated. The occasional lag because for some reason my computer can't handle it. Let's turn around. Figure out what's... Oh, hello. Clear the way a little bit. I'm going to kill a few of these guys, see if I can get anything good. Like as far as weapons and stuff. Or, not weapons, ammo. So we'll kind of just take anything at this point. Just so we're kind of prepared, because we're coming up on a pretty long section, I believe. Not get hit by you and your weird twin brother. Alright, make sure there's no one behind us, because that's the last thing we need, is to have someone come up behind us and murder us again. Alright. Or I guess, kill us anyway. Man, this game is a lot, like, the newer ones are a lot more generous than the older ones, because I don't ever remember picking up, like, thousands of dollars from, like, one enemy. But in the Wii version, PlayStation, and the GameCube version. But for some reason in the HD remakes, it's like a billion times easier to get money. Which kind of sucks because it takes away some of the challenge just because you're able to upgrade it almost at will. I mean, they do cap out like what you can upgrade. Which is good and bad to me because it kind of stops you from having a super overpowered weapon early in the game and just having only using one of them, or only using one weapon instead of making you use the other ones. But you know, that's life. Let's just, yeah, so when we go down, because we're gonna see the merchant again, we're going to talk to him. We're just gonna buy a bigger case. I wanted to hold off on getting one, and I think I'm alright with just getting rid of a shell to get more TNP ammo. Because like I said before, that gun is going to be super useful to us. It's just a really good machine gun. I can't think of any more off the top of my head that are even in the game. I know there's like the Matilda or whatever that uses pistol ammo, the 9mm ammo, and that's pretty good, but it's also a ammo hog. I'm pretty sure it even says it in the exclusive upgrade. Something that might interest you. Got a selection. Well, it could have been worse. And we're going to shoot the medallions because we do want that extra, we want that the handgun, because I think I'm just going to run through with that one instead of this one, because I want to do something new and I guess not do the same thing over and over again in runs or in playthroughs, because I believe in the first one I was going to stick with the pistol. And we're going to find a gem for this mask here later on. So, and for this beer stein as well. We're going to get it here in probably the next 5-10 minutes, I want to say. But we're going to upgrade that real quick. We'll buy a bigger case because that's going to be a little useful to us. Buy this. And we're going to have to move some stuff around. and I'm weird, so it has to be like right next to the gun to be aesthetically pleasing. Can't put that there. All right, hold on. We're gonna mess with our inventory a little bit. We're gonna clean this stuff up. That's cool. Well, let's move this here. Does this need an entire? Because if so, come on. We're wasting valuable time. Let's move our guns over here for now. I mean, once we get rid of this fish, we can mess with it again. There we go. Favorite part of the game is just playing with your inventory to get stuff to fit, and so you can buy like the bigger weapons attachments, or the bigger case for that matter. Which isn't necessarily a bad thing to spend your money on. There is better things you can spend it on, obviously, like upgrading your weapons, getting first aid sprays and stuff. So there's a church. I wonder if I can. There's got to be some way to. I don't know if a flash grenade does it. Yeah. There's like one of them that gives you a ridiculous amount of money. So far, not a ridiculous amount of money. I guess not. Maybe I just got lucky. I kind of zoomed through when I was playing on the Xbox 360, and I could have swore one of those. That was weird. She was still flash stunned, I guess. And can you not? Oh, maybe that's why. Yikes. One of the times I was playing through on the 360, I ran into this thing where I killed those crows, or ravens, whatever you want to call them, and I got one of them dropped like $9,800, which I couldn't believe because that's very generous, especially since the most I can remember picking up aside from that is 3,300, which we got in this game. And maybe it was 900, maybe it was 800, and I just kind of fused the two. I don't know. I just remembered seeing that and thinking, wow, that is very amazing. And if that can happen, like, all the time, that would be sweet. Oh, come on, hit it. Thank you. See, and we gotta get it again, which is kind of good for us because we just kind of turn over the money that we spent on upgrading our inventory and our weapons. And also the fact that we want to get the Punisher as soon as possible so we can upgrade it and get it to where we need to get it so we can kind of keep up on them. Now we're gonna do this puzzle, which lets us get. Alright, we should wait for him to light it. There we go. My bad, I should have waited for him to do it. But oh well. Now this is to get one of the cast eyes for the beer stein. Which is, it's not really important, but I like to do it because it makes me feel important. I want to go there. And that should open her up. We take it. And we'll take this few seconds to do that. And we're almost done with that. Spoiler alert, we're not going to be able to finish either one of the items we have until a little bit later in the game. I like how some of the people think, like, it's so easy just to, you know, break the almost a princess, the president's daughter from a group of insane villagers. And I can't hit the broadside of a barn. But it's the fact that she got stolen by a group of villagers. Like, first off, how did that happen? Do they, like, break into the White House or something? Or do they come over to America and take her? And if they did, shouldn't the president's daughter have some kind of, like, security guards or something? You're telling me that these village people... I can't hit that thing. This is embarrassing. You're telling me that the Secret Service or whatever can't... That would have been even worse if I died to that snake. Can we... Oh my god. Please, snake. Oh my lord. Wow. Okay, well, it looks like we're getting rid of this bass. I'm putting my stuff back to where it was because I'm not a fan of this whole keeping the weapons on the right side. I'm old school. I want to keep them on the left. There we go. Done. We'll worry about it later. And I wasted a bunch of ammo trying to kill a snake and shoot a medallion that I could have gotten closer to. And the snake I just have no excuse for. I can't hit the broadside of a barn, so... Okay, apparently I couldn't kick you, even though I think I should have still had the animation for it. Let's just miss a few more shots, why not? It wouldn't be a Dakota playthrough if I didn't unload an entire clip into a basic enemy and almost not kill it. This flash grenade. Kill all of them. It's just a lot of money, and it kind of... And with that one, it's basically free to kind of do that. Just because you do pick up a flash grenade. Pick up some of the items here. Before we continue on. That way we don't have to worry about it when we get here. Actually, I think they respawn. I believe. Yeah, because normally when you come in here, or during the mini boss fight that's going to happen later, there's items in there that are supposed to help you. You know, there's ammo, there's treasures and stuff. Let's... I want to find that other medallion. I might just wait to do that, and I don't think I have anything that I need right this second. You can go down there, and the merchants down there and everything, and I believe that there's a treasure, but we'll wait to do that when we come back. We don't have any real need to do it now, and this episode is running at 20 minutes long, and I don't want to have to cut it into two parts, so... Let's just kind of speed run through this after we get chased by a boulder. Alright. So we're going to be able to find another treasure. There we go, that's what we want. Want this to go as smooth as possible. Because I really don't want it to keep going through this section. Because it's really annoying. Shoot that. Wow, that was very lucky. Want to blow that up. There's a treasure here. There's a snake in my water. Maybe that was a snake from earlier. That explains why I can't hit it. Snake is invincible. a very not solid snake. Alright, I've done enough puns for myself. Enough bad puns, anyway. Let's just hurry up and get through this. I like how I keep saying hurry up, as in, like, I'm telling someone else to hurry up and just play through this so we can continue on. I'm literally the only one that controls how fast I go, and I keep dirtling. Go away. Go away. So close. My goodness. I'm cutting all of this very close. And by cutting it close, I mean like 90% of the time I'm just getting grabbed anyway. Cat-like reflexes, boys and girls. So let's keep moving. I think this is where we get to. Yeah, okay, so we're coming up on the end of the chapter. We're gonna kind of play around here for just a second so we can grab this. Grab extra ammo and all that fun stuff. Even though it really doesn't matter for this. Because we're gonna be in a boat. And that's how we're gonna fight the first boss. But it doesn't hurt to kind of get this stuff out of the way, because I believe it resets after this fight. And we just want to get as much stuff as we can. It's kind of like in professional mode. You just want to be able to get as much stuff as you can. Actually, I'm going to save real quick, because I'm going to show you guys something that I think is pretty funny. Save real quick. So I'm not sure what's going to spit me back out, and if it's not going to put me back here, then I want to make sure I can get back to that so we don't waste any time. And that's what happens when you try to shoot the fish in the water before you kill the boss. He eats you alive. That's one death that I'm fine with. But now we don't waste any resources or anything. And that's a sneak peek of who we're going to fight. Spoilers. Oh, bless me. Alright, so now here we are. Going with our little propeller boat. And that's how our ancestors used to ride in boats. They just tie it to a giant lake monster. Oh god, I turned right into him. When in doubt, always go right. Come on, Leon, swim. You don't have time to mess around. This huge thing is gonna eat you. What I don't understand is why he, when he does that, he just doesn't eat the boat. Because he knows, or I guess he doesn't know that you're on it. But at the same time, it kind of make more sense. And he is kind of attached to it anyway, but where are you? There you are, Nessy. Come on. I just want to try to get as many hits on him as I can. Just so we don't have to keep messing around with this fight. Because this fight is not really tough, but you're just avoiding all the stuff that's in the lake. And then having to do that stuff and not having waste an opportunity like I just did. It just gets kind of, it's kind of rough. Because you just want to kind of get through this fight just so you can get on with like the rest of the game. Because it's not tough, just more the fact that it can be long and drawn out, because it's literally just hinges on your ability to, you know, riding along with the sea monster. It hinges on your ability to just get as many hits on them as you can. And we're gonna, okay, we're good. I could have gotten probably one or two more. Alright, so now we're gonna find him again. Listen here for a minute. Oh. That's not good. Why is there a... There we go. So that boss fight is done. Down goes Nessy. There's some death animations I like in this game. That one is not one, because it is kind of cheap, because you just spend like a few minutes trying to beat the boss, or I guess the boss of the chapter, and if you're not fast enough, or if you just kind of think, okay, it's done, I can leave and come back, you can just die. That's weird. It just kind of, the sound went way faster than the actual video. That's weird. But that's going to do it for chapter 1. We're going to move on to chapter 2. If you guys like the video, make sure you leave a like and comments. Comment what kind of games you guys want to see next, or if there's something that I'm missing that you want to see me do in the game. And yeah, all that good stuff. A little bit longer of an episode because I turtled around, kept dying. But we'll get through it eventually. But yeah, I'll see you guys in the next episode.